Hello everyone, it's DE here. Hope you guys are doing great. Hope you are doing amazing. I'm sure that when DE announced Warframe on the Nintendo Switch at TennoCon 2018, a lot of us were filled with excitement. We were so happy, mainly because that means we will be able to take Warframe, a game that we love, we will be able to take it on the go. I mean, though the graphical fidelity of the game may be a little bit different on the Switch, but we still love the idea of a Warframe game on a Nintendo Switch, which is basically the full game, the full experience. Seconds after that announcement of that venture, DE and their devs started receiving numerous tweets and questions about account transfers and sharing, if possible. And of course, such news would go unnoticed if there weren't so many tweets about crossplay. Crossplay is going to be the latest and biggest issue when it comes to gaming right now. With Warframe coming to the Nintendo Switch, that will also mean that the company has fully covered all bases on all major platforms. We all know about the recent issue with Fortnite players and Sony and accounts being banned because Sony is locking players out of it. They don't want them to use their accounts somewhere else. And chances are, Microsoft and Nintendo will be open to this if Warframe decides to go into it, but Sony might not be because of financial reasons, and a lot of us already know that. Now, if crossplay of such is allowed, most PS4 players might end up going to the mobile, which is going to be with the Nintendo Switch, and some of them might even go to the Xbox One for a much better graphical fidelity, so we can already see where that is going right now. And in an interview with TechRadar, DE's very own Sheldon Carter spoke about these concerns and also talked about the future of cross-platform gaming in general. DE said that they are investigating those possibilities for their players and what we will be able to do in the future. And they also spoke about the seamless account transition as well, which is also one of the recent ones that we've been seeing to be announced. Now, the future of cross-platform gaming in general is a big thing. It is really crazy. I see the positives of it, and I also see the negatives of it. So far, Digital Extremes have been able to execute the one-time account migration, which could be from PC to console or from console to PC. However, cross-platform is still a big issue. But here is where those problems will begin to roll in if crossplay is allowed. All updates will have to be cert and released at the same time for both PC and console players. And right now, as we already know, consoles usually get their updates 3 to 4 weeks after PC does, because PC seems to come out with a lot of bugs. We are the beta testers. We are basically the ones they use as guinea pigs before they finally release it for console. So that is very important. The second issue in question is going to be the controls and the performances. With consoles right now, a controller will perform differently from how a mouse and a keyboard would. Though DE is trying to blur the lines between both of them, however, we all know that there's still a long way to go. The other issue will also be tied to the network fidelity, the ping system, the servers, the peer-to-peer system. That is also going to be a big thing for a lot of us. How would server sharing work? Consoles have to go through their platform's database to connect to others, and that can be very dangerous ground for hacks and possible attacks. I will, however, say that the cross-platform thing is a possibility if it is on all consoles except for PC, because that will also be less intrusive and less threatening. Now, the thing is that DE's stance on this is still to look further into it, and I'm thinking they still want to wait for the Nintendo Switch version to come out, see what is possible, talk to a lot of these devs and a lot of these CEOs and see what they can do. Now, DE is able to make these constant patches and updates because of the clauses that are in place. The formal agreement is that a game can have multiple updates as long as they are still in beta. So if DE decide to launch today, they will not be able to do that. However, that is also one of the big clauses that a lot of major companies and a lot of major studios are trying to fight against so that they're able to update their games as much as they want. Now, this also gives some companies creative freedom, and which is why DE is able to get away with things that Fortnite will not be able to as of this moment. And with that said, what are your thoughts about crossplay in general? Would you like to see that in Warframe? And if possible, would you just prefer crossplay on consoles only except for PC? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. If you enjoyed this video, feel free to leave a thumbs up, share the video, and also subscribe to the channel for more content. And if you so choose, you can also support the channel in other ways, including a direct PayPal and a monthly subscription on Patreon. Thanks for watching this video. Hope you enjoyed. I'll see you in the next one.